I attain Buddha and sentient beings in the 10 directions upon hearing my name, continuously being mindful of my land, planting roots of virtue and sincerely transferring their merits towards seeking rebirth in my land. Should their wish not be fulfilled, may I not attain perfect enlightenment. If I attain Buddha and heavenly beings and humans in my land, should they not all possess the 32 signs of a great being, may I not attain perfect enlightenment. If I attain Buddha and Bodhisattvas or other Buddha lands will come to be born in my land, will all attain to the stage of becoming a Buddha in their next life, except for those with original vows. They can manifest in the wearing the armor of great vows, for sentient beings accumulate merit to liberate all, travel to all Buddha lands and practice the Bodhisattva path. Make offerings to all Tathagata Buddhas in the 10 directions, awaken countless beings like the Ganges, and so they can be on the path of the Supreme Truth, surpassing ordinary Bodhisattvas, and cultivate the merit of Samatabhadra. If these cannot be realized, may I not attain perfect enlightenment. If I attain Buddhahood, Bodhisattvas in my land, to make offerings to the Buddhas within the time of, should they not reach countless, measureless, millions of nayutas of Buddha lands, may I not attain perfect enlightenment. If I attain Buddha and Bodhisattvas in my land, can manifest their merit in front of all Buddhas, should the offerings of the Bodhisattvas' desire not be fulfilled, may I not attain perfect enlightenment. If I attain Buddha and Bodhisattvas in my land, should they not be able to found the Dharma with all encompassing wisdom, may I not attain perfect enlightenment. If I attain Buddha and Bodhisattvas in my land, should they not attain the bodies of Vajranarayana, may I not attain perfect enlightenment. If I attain Buddha and heavenly beings, humans, and everything in my land are pure, magnificent, with special shapes and colors, incredibly delicate, wonderful, and impossible to be praised and measured, even for beings who have attained the divine eye, if they can distinguish their names and numbers, may I not attain perfect enlightenment. If I attain Buddha, Bodhisattvas in my land, even those with little merit, should they not be able to know and see the trees of Bodhimanda, which have been in light with 4 million lee at night, may I not attain perfect enlightenment. If I attain Buddha and Bodhisattvas in my land, should they not acquire eloquence and wisdom by accepting and reciting the sutras, upholding and expounding the Dharma, may I not attain perfect enlightenment. If I attain Buddha and Bodhisattvas in my land, should their wisdom and eloquence be limited, may I not attain perfect enlightenment. If I attain Buddha, then my land will be pure and can reflect countless innumerable and inconceivable Buddha lands like a clear mirror reflects one's face. If this cannot be realized, may I not attain perfect enlightenment. If I attain Buddha, from the ground to the sky, palaces, pavilions, pond streams, flowers, and trees, everything in my land will be composed of countless treasures and hundreds of thousands of fragrances. The adornments are so wonderful that they surpass all the heavenly beings. Their fragrance pervade all the worlds of the 10 directions. And when the Bodhisattvas smell them, they will all cultivate the Buddhist practices. If this cannot be realized, may I not attain perfect enlightenment. If I attain Buddha and sentient beings in the immeasurable and inconceivable Buddha lands of the 10 directions, who have been touched by my light, their bodies and hearts will be softer than heavenly beings. If this cannot be realized, may I not attain perfect enlightenment. If I attain Buddha and sentient beings in the immeasurable and inconceivable Buddha lands of the 10 directions, upon hearing my name, should they not gain the Bodhisattva's insight into the dawn arising of all dharmas and not acquire various profound dharanis, may I not attain perfect enlightenment. If I attain Buddha, in the immeasurable and inconceivable Buddha directions, upon hearing my name, rejoice in faith and rate the bodhicitta, wish to renounce inertia. The day after death be reborn again, as women may I not attain perfect enlightenment. If I attain Buddha, bodhisattvas in the immeasurable and inconceivable Buddha lands of the ten directions, upon hearing my name after their deaths, will constantly cultivate brahmacharya practices until they reach Buddhahood. If this cannot be realized, may I not attain perfect enlightenment. If I attain Buddhahood, heavenly beings and humans in the immeasurable and inconceivable Buddha lands of the ten directions, upon hearing my name, draws with themselves on the ground to revere and honor me, rejoice and bathe and cultivate the bodhisattva practices. Should they not be respected by all heavenly beings and humans of all worlds, may I not attain perfect enlightenment. If I attain Buddhahood, heavenly beings and humans in my land, should they desire clothes, can obtain them according to their thoughts, like the Buddhas whose wonderful clothes are naturally worn. Should they require soaking, bleaching, dyeing, or washing, may I not attain perfect enlightenment. If I attain Buddhahood, heavenly beings and humans in my land, should the happiness they enjoy be less than those beings who have extinguished all the mental defilements, may I not attain perfect enlightenment. If I attain Buddhahood, bodhisattvas who are in my land, whenever they wish to see the immeasurable, glorious, and pure Buddha lands of the ten directions, they can fulfill their wish right then and see all of them reflected in the jewel trees, just like seeing the image of one's face in a clear mirror. If this cannot be realized, may I not attain perfect enlightenment. If I attain Buddhahood, all the bodhisattvas from other worlds, upon hearing my name, until they reach Buddhahood, should they suffer any lack or imperfection in their faculties, may I not attain perfect enlightenment. If I attain Buddhahood, all the bodhisattvas from other worlds, upon hearing my name, should they not obtain the samadhi of pure liberation, while abiding in the samadhi, one instant be able to make offerings to immeasurable and inconceivable Buddha's world, honor ones without losing their meditative state, may I not attain perfect enlightenment. If I attain Buddhahood, all the bodhisattvas from other worlds, upon hearing my name, will be reborn into the noble families after death. If this cannot be realized, may I not attain perfect enlightenment. If I attain Buddhahood, all the bodhisattvas from other worlds, upon hearing my name, jump with great joy, cultivate the bodhisattva practices, and be full of merit. If this cannot be fully realized, may I not attain perfect enlightenment. If I attain Buddhahood, all the bodhisattvas from other worlds, upon hearing my name, will all attain the samadhi of the universal equality. They will abide in the samadhi until they attain Buddhahood, and they would constantly see all the immeasurable and inconceivable Buddhas. If this cannot be realized, may I not attain perfect enlightenment. If I attain Buddhahood, bodhisattvas in my land can hear naturally whatever dharma they wish to hear in accordance with their aspirations and vows. If this cannot be realized, may I not attain perfect enlightenment. If I attain Buddhahood, all the bodhisattvas from other worlds, upon hearing my name, should they not instantly reach the stage of non-regression, may I not attain perfect enlightenment. If I attain Buddhahood, all the bodhisattvas from other worlds, upon hearing my name, should they not instantly gain the first, second, and third tolerance of dharma, and not instantly reach the stage of non-regression amongst all dharma, may I not attain perfect enlightenment. Namo Amitabha Buddha. Namo. Ah.